And now we will learn how to create estimates. The main contract estimate shows the details of each product or service provided on a project or job. The estimate's information comes from the contract and it helps you track the progress of that contract. You must activate estimates in the preferences window. If you don't, you will not be able to enter estimates or see any of the reports that are there. In this file, estimates have not yet been activated. If you click the customer pull-down menu, you will not see a choice to create estimates. The same is true for the reports main menu under jobs, time, and mileage, where all of the estimate reports usually are. Notice if you click reports, jobs, time, and mileage, you will not see any reports for estimates because in this file, the estimates have not been activated. If you want to activate the estimates, you have to open the preferences window. From the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. The choice on the left in the preferences window is Jobs and Estimates, and then click Company Preference. Now, it says here, do you create estimates? We will click Yes. We will not yet touch these two buttons here on the right. For now, just click the yes, then click OK. You will notice your file has changed. Now when you click customers from the main menu, there is a choice to create estimates because you just activated it. You should also look at the reports main menu under jobs, time, and mileage, and now you can see there are specific reports for estimates that have been placed here after you activated estimates in the preferences window. The first report that we will work with regarding estimates is the Estimates by Job report. That's because it shows every estimate ever entered into the file that has not yet been deleted. From the main menu, click Reports, Jobs, Time, and Mileage, Estimates by Job. Right now, there are nothing. Make sure the Date pull-down menu says All, regardless of date. So right now there are no estimates in the file, but we do need this report right after we make our first estimates. So at the moment this report window is the active window, we go to the top left of the main menu and click View, Add Estimates by Job to the icon bar. Click OK, and now we have ourselves a shortcut to one of the main estimate reports. Before we record our first estimate, you should know that estimates are not transactions. They will not affect the customer's balance regarding how much they owe. They will not affect the trial balance, chart of accounts, or general ledger. They will not show in the journal, but they will show up on the audit trail report. And they have their own special reports, like the one we just pinned to the top of the icon bar. So, example 1. January 1, we made estimate number 1 for the Hampton Place job under Brown Company. The items on the estimate are 25 units of carpentry at $60 each, 25 units of electrical work at $80 each, 25 replacement parts at $75 each, and 25 units of steam cleaning at $55 each. And we can refer back to this as we record the estimate. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Estimates. Notice, estimate number 1 should come up first. However, mine came up as estimate number 2 because I was practicing with creating estimates. Choose the job. The customer is Brown and the specific job is Hanson Place. The date of the estimate is January 1 and we will assume that's January 1 of 2017. Now, the items we will read from the sheet a moment ago. It's carpentry, electrical, replacement parts, and steam cleaning. Carpentry, replacement, electrical, replacement parts, and steam cleaning. Now, the quantity of each was 25. Now, the cost per item we'll have to read off here, 60, 80, 75, and 55. So, $60 each. Push the tab key on your keyboard. Click OK for the price level warning. $80 each. Just keep hitting tab on your keyboard. What were the remaining two? 75 and 55. $75 each. And 55. Okay, now we have all the information we need for our first estimate. We click Save and Close, and when we open the Estimates by Job report, we see the estimate is here, the estimate is active, here's the total amount, and we could always double-click, go back and look at the estimate, and we could change anything we need. Let's try a second example. January 2, we made estimate number 2 for the Mockingbird Lane job under the same company, Brown Company. It's 25 units of 4 different items, and these are different items that were on, different from the previous estimate. Let's make them the same way. From the main menu, well, after you click Save and Close for this one, from the main menu, click Customers, Create Estimate. Of course, it's still Brown Company, but this time it's Mockingbird Lane. The date on the second estimate is January 2, and the items are as follows. Dewinterizing, mason work. So let's choose dewinterizing and mason work. And now let's choose replacement pipes, not parts, and steam cleaning. Replacement pipes and steam cleaning. And the quantity is 25 for each of them. And the unit cost for each is as follows. Let's just read it off the sheet. 65, 85, 70, and 50. So we have 65, 85, 70, and 50. Okay, now we have another estimate. It's estimate number 2 on January 2nd, and even though it's the same company, it's still under, it's a different job, it's Mockingbird Lane. When we click Save and Close, we can check it in Estimates by Job. Under Brown Company, the Hanson Place estimate has an estimate of 6,750, and the Mockingbird Lane job has an estimate for 6,750.